tackle and it's recovered by Washington. Wilbur Marshall. Wilbur Marshall still on his feet. And he laterals the ball to Alvord Mays.
It's the Redskin Postgame Show with Ken Mease and Doc Walker.
Well, good afternoon, everybody. Certainly that play we saw on the bump was very definitive of what happened at RFK today. Wilbur Marshall's interception, one of five the Redskins had today. They broke out offensively and defensively 41-3 over the Phoenix Cardinals. And, Doc, in addition to the superb play of the Redskins secondary, I really felt that as this game got going and unfolded, that the most important factor was Jim Lachey's returning. I think not so much that he was 100% or anything else, but for the first time in a long, long time, the offensive lineman lined up in position and went through a ball game without having to go right tackle to left guard and center to right tackle and what have you. Right?
No doubt about it. I thought it was really significant to have Jim Lachey in uniform and for him to play well and to prove that the leg was well enough for him to go the entire game. Also, that of Darryl Green being back in the lineup. Although they went deep one play to heel, he showed he could come back and play. And they didn't lose anybody from that standpoint. Ed Simmons was forced to come in for a few plays. Ray Brown was nicked, but he came back. So believe it or not, they showed that the injured replaced the injured, and they were able to still keep it abreast.
And Ray Brown had the critical block on the one short running play for the touchdown.
Certainly did.
Blew him back. Al Koken is down at RFK, and let's check in with Al. Al, what do you have for us?
All right, well, Ken and Doc, you can certainly imagine a circus atmosphere out here. Not only is the pressure off this team, but I think a lot of pressure off these fans. And you saw the Redskins come out and convincingly beat the Phoenix Cardinals, but they did it with a lot of razzle-dazzle, a lot of excitement that got this crowd into the game. And, of course, as Brad Edwards and that defensive unit led the way with the great turnovers, preventing Phoenix from getting anything going, it really was a very dominating defensive performance, and they set the tone, and it really got this crowd back in the game as well. They were celebrating everything. I mean, how do you like seeing Brian Mitchell lining up at quarterback, Mark Rypien at wide receiver? They were doing all kinds of things, and that really pumped this unit up, this team up, and the stadium up as well.
Okay, Al, the feeling down there, could you tell, you know, game faces, as they say, as you were on the field there and this club came out, was there a different attitude, a different expression about them that you could see they were ready for this, so to speak?
Yeah, I mean, it looked also, Ken, like a great deal of confidence was back in this team, and I think as much psychological, just seeing Jim Lachey in the lineup, just seeing Darryl Green in the starting lineup, having a little bit of health, and also it couldn't have hurt the fact that they know that they've handled Phoenix very successfully in this city. They may have had a little trouble out in Phoenix earlier in the year, but they certainly handled Phoenix very well in the past, and I think that had a lot of confidence. And one of the things that I talked to a lot of the guys after the game about as they were coming off the field was whether they needed a blowout as much as they needed a victory.
Did you guys need a blowout as much as you needed a victory?
I tell you what, we needed some touchdowns. You know, that made us feel a little better. You know, we needed a game like this. A big defensive game, big offense. I mean, special teams roles. Everybody played together. So we needed one like this. We hope we can just rise right now.
All right, thank you.
Did you guys need a blowout as much as you needed a victory?
No. I think a victory is nice, but it's great to get a blowout. Yeah.
What was the key to getting this offensive going again today?
I think just getting in there and getting the running game going again and giving Rypien time to throw the ball, and it worked out.
Is this the type of game that gives you guys now confidence to take with you the rest of the season?
Yeah, I hope so. You know, I think it's something that we've desperately been looking for and wanting, and, you know, I think it's just all been an attitude. We've been so banged up and I think feeling a little sorry for ourselves and just put it aside and said, hey, we got to go out and win this one. So, you know, so we can take care of the rest of the season.
We can see what Lachey does on the field, but psychologically, just seeing him back there lining up a tackle, that had to be a big boost for your unit.
Yeah, it's nice. You know, it's nice to have Jimmy and have the guys that, you know, have played offensive line for us for a long time. And so it's great to have him back.
So there was a running game for a change. There was the passing game, some offensive touchdowns, and the defense continues to turn in big plays. It all adds up to a big blowout here at RFK. Ken, back to you and Doc.
Al, I only had a question for you. How about on the sidelines? Well, Ken, sidelines.
Here he is.
Al,
he's
you
back.
With us?
He's
hey, Al. Give me one second, my man. About the sideline demeanor of the posse. I mean, it's been a long time since we've seen the three of them get in the end zone, especially for Monk to have scored, but Sanders started off real well, and Clark, who's had some problems, showed that he could get back in the pay dirt.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you could see Gary Clark, when he caught his touchdown pass, he walked right by us as we were standing on the sidelines. and he still had that angry look on his face, but everybody around him was boosting him up, the pat on the back, and then the place went crazy. The Redskins sideline, I mean, half the team was out on the field to greet Art Monk. So getting those guys in the posse going, as you know, Doc, so important to this team, and also giving Kerry Conklin a little bit of a boost. If they do have to have Conklin somewhere down the line, now he's got a little confidence. So all the way around, the big performers that needed to get going for this team got going today, and that's why you can spread this confidence all around the 45 men on this club.
Al, for the record, I don't think they needed a blowout as much as they just needed a victory.
Well, it didn't hurt. I mean, it certainly makes things a lot easier when you don't have to worry about one mistake costing you a ball game. You know how this team can get. You throw an interception when the score is relatively close, and people are going to start thinking it's the Phoenix game in Phoenix all over again. I think that blowout really took everybody's mind at ease.
Okay, Joe Gibbs is holding forth in his post-game news conference. Let's check in on that.
It certainly helps solidify things a little bit. We looked a little different there, and our defense has been just tremendous. That's been the case all year. Defense and teams have really led us. Offense is still, we're still off, but hopefully a little better today, I think, and then hopefully we kind of hit a groove here at some point.
Seems kind of odd how the Phoenix two games could be so pivotal this year.
Yeah, I really felt like this was a critical game, like I said. I said it 2 weeks ago that, you know, I didn't think we could drop both these, and you know, it would have put us in a bind. We could have still done it. You know, we'd had to win probably three out of the last four against, you know, and we got some tough people coming up. Everybody knows that. So I think, hey, we're 7-5. And we haven't looked good at times, but we're 7-5 and gird ourselves each week and see, take our best shot from here on out and see if we can find a way to get in there.
What do you have to say about Edwards today?
I think Brad before the game, too, really, I felt like exhibited a lot of leadership and tried to kind of take things in his hands, you know, and try and get us going. And I really think he was one of the guys that tried to stand up. And I said going into this game, hey, the Redskins need this bad. In the past, we've had guys stand up, and I think Brad's one of those guys that did that.
Is there anybody offensively who took charge?
I think we got some, you know, we got a great group over there. We've had some tough times, and some of us hadn't played, you know, played as good or coached as good as we could. Could have probably, but I think we got great heart. Hey, I'm the Lord's blessed us here with some great character people, and I think that's what we got, and hopefully we can keep rolling here at some point, get some kind of a groove down the stretch. I'm hoping somehow we kind of hit a groove for us here last 4 weeks.
Joe, normally you finish with the same quarterback you started with, but what made you change your mind today?
Well, I think that I just kind of felt the situation and get Kerry in there, and I really probably shouldn't have thrown that last time, but I wanted him to get a couple of throws, you know, just to get him in there. He's worked hard all this time and hadn't had a chance to play. So, at different times I put people in. I just felt like today was a good time to put him in.
What did Joe say to you after the game?
We just waved at each other.
What did he say to you during the game?
Mike?
What was he yelling from the other side for about a minute?
I don't know. I didn't hear that. When was that? Was that
after the Mike yelling out?
Oh, was it? Yeah, maybe he may have been upset with me. I don't know.
So just before the half, was that Shane Collins in the fullback position on your goal line?
To what?
Just before the half, was that Shane Collins lined up?
Yeah, Shane's played fullback for us someday.
New look there?
Yeah, well, we kind of took a vote on the team. He came out as the guy most explosive that can get things done at fullback, so we took a shot with him.
Coach, what do you have to say about the putting Brian Mitchell at quarterback and ripping it receiver?
Yeah, we just felt like that, you know, this is a game that we had to have. We went to take a few shots with some special plays, and then we had several of them in there for Brian and got a chance to use a couple of them. And, you know, it was just as part of our special plays, trying to get our spirits up a little bit, like trying to get everybody in the act. He's one of the guys that's had a great year, and I got him in there to take a few shots.
Did you devise that player once again?
Now, which one's that?
The one with Mitchell on the quarterback.
No, that was offensively. That was ours. That was offense.
Passing game, especially in the first and fourth quarters, a little more rhythm, a little more sync to it today.
Yeah, I think that we still are. You know, we're just not really. I wouldn't say in a real good groove. You know, passing. We get the big drop there for an interception, and Rip throws one there. You know, in the third quarter. I think that. But I think hopefully we kind of got ourselves a little bit of a groove here, and hopefully it'll carry over down the road.
How about Rip's performance in general?
I think he missed a few things, but I think he also hit some and did a good job of competing.
What about the difference in pass protection this week compared to previous?
Big difference.
Same line as last week in New Orleans. He missed some and he hit some.
He hit 50-50.
We were watching the game, though. You mentioned Brian Mitchell, the quarterback, that Joe had to make it fun again. I think he did that.
It means a lot when you get out and practice, and especially when you're down a little bit. He's done this in the past. You remember Russ Grimmett, quarterback? Mm-hmm. That meant a lot within the circle of players because it breaks you. It gives you some spirit. You start kidding around in practice. Offense has got to be fun. And when you've heard so much about the posse and this inability to score and Rip missing some things, so that was something to kind of put guys at ease. Good move.
More interviews from RFK and, game highlights when the Redskin postgame show continues.
The Redskin postgame show. Brought to you by the CNP Telephone Yellow Pages. No other book can match it. A Bell Atlantic company. And by your local Toyota dealer, where you'll find great values like the all-new Toyota Corolla. For quality, value, and the best deal going, see your local Toyota dealer today.
Shop! My mama told me you better shop around. Shop, shop around. You better shop around. My mama told me you better shop around.
I always go to the shopping center 9 out of 10 people use.
The genuine CNP telephone yellow pages. 9 out of 10 use it. No other book can match it. A Bell Atlantic company.
The storm gathers her players, thunder and lightning. The wind rises and shakes its fist at the earth. The sky is falling and everyone scurries for cover. Who would choose to be out on a night like this? Who else? Because we're connected to the people we serve by more than power lines. Pepco.
Here's a great idea for the holiday weekend. Save some money.
Saving money, I like that.
Then see your Toyota dealer now. There's great holiday deals on Camrys, Tercels, Corollas, and Celicas. Some have option package savings up to $1,500. The values are terrific.
I got a great deal.
Holiday deals means Toyota's priced to sell now. There's Chump Toyota trucks with factory to dealer incentives. It only lasts a few days, so get to your Toyota dealer today.
Safe and courteous drivers could be found all over this country. Today, these drivers are a vanishing breed. But we know you're out there. And we built a car insurance company just for you. Geico, we have only one policy, safety.
It's a leather jacket price break from Today's Man. Choose oversized bombers in six styles. $200 at department stores, just $99 at Today's Man. Handsome three-quarter length leather jackets, $325 at department stores, just $199 at Today's Man. Or luxurious full-length coats in the most supple leather, not $400, just $199. Great leathers, 30 to 40% below department stores. From Today's Man, the men's store with a different set of values.
41-3, the Redskins over the Cardinals today, and Doc, they brought it up in the CBS telecast, 106-3 in the last three games here. Cardinals have not won at RFK since 1978. That's 14 games, so it's what the doctor ordered for this Redskin club now. And let's take a look at the first quarter highlights, okay. Because when this game really got going, it a little shaky for the Redskins on that first series as the Cardinals moved the ball very well, ran the ball very well, and you think they got away from the run a little bit too soon, albeit Larry Setters gets the 25-yard catch to the 25-yard line, set up a Greg Davis 42-yard field goal, and the Cardinals were ahead 3-0 and looked like they were ready to play.
No one had stopped Ivory at that point. I think they got out of their game plan. Setters had been the big guy for them in their last meeting, got away from what was working.
After the kickoff, the Redskins drove it about 80 yards, and the key man was Ricky Sanders. Three catches for 43 yards on this drive. That's a 16-yard out pattern to the sideline, just tiptoed in. And then the 13-yard touchdown pass. Nice play action, roll out by Mark Rypien. And Sanders gets into the pylon there and makes it 7-3. Second touchdown catch of the year for Ricky Sanders. And then Brad Edwards came up big as he started a tremendous day. He really had trouble in New Orleans last week, but redeemed himself this week. This is about a 53-yard interception return for the touchdown by Brad Edwards. Picks up the convoy and gets it easily once he gets to about the 20-yard line. 14-3 after that, and Brad Edwards was in on this next play. I got one ahead of myself. This is the Darryl Green play. Welcome back, Darryl. Randall Hill on the fly.
Yes, indeed. Again, that's going to happen because he's going to play you man-to-man, but as always, he always comes back and makes a play.
Okay, now Brad Edwards comes back into the scene along with Fred Stokes and Wilbur Marshall, and watch this hip on Larry Centers.
Centers again.
Watch this. Boom, 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 and down he goes, and now watch they talk trash to him. All three of them are over south of Mr. Centers.
Wilbur Marshall, you got to love him. Edwards was really possessed today. You made a good point out. New Orleans was not his best game.
And they missed a 30-yard field goal right after that, and the first quarter ended with the Redskins on top 14-3. At RFK now is quarterback coach Rod Dowhower. And, Rod, let's get to you and ask you about this Brian Mitchell thing at quarterback here. How did that unfold this week? Whose idea was it? How did it get into the game package?
Well, about early in the morning when those jet planes started taking off out of Dulles, that came up.
About 4 a.m., Rocket?
You're about right. Yeah, we just thought Brian was doing such a good job at all other phases of his game, which really right now is the special teams, that, hey, why not take a shot? And he responded very well. He was really excited. During the week in practice, he kept saying, Coach, are we ready for that play? He did a good job.
Does it also work to the positive side for Mark Rypien in terms of his psyche to get something in different to make it fun again?
Well, we needed that, period. You know, it's easy to get down and get in the doldrums with the way things have been going the past few weeks, and we just wanted to give a little different look to the defense and also put the ball in a good football player's hands.
I understand it was strictly mop-up duty when Kerry Conklin went in already 34-3, but with some of the winds that have been swirling the last couple of weeks, is there any risk to putting Conklin in? I know you want him to do well, but the fact he does well, everybody sees that, hey, this kid can play, and, you know, the fuel is there for a future fire.
Well, I think it's a very small one. And I know that doesn't exist in our organization right now. Bottom line is, Mark came back, he had a couple shaky plays, but he came back, made a big one to Gary Clark, and then we got to the end of the game, and we just said, hey, why don't we give Kerry some work? He's been so good in practice and doing all the things we asked that we just felt he needed some work and get the exposure, and he responded quite well.
Rod, as you look back, and I want to go back to practice and look at the little things, the mechanics with Mark Rypien, had one pass today, really a bad decision through into double coverage, on interception, one that could have been intercepted. What do you think is going through his mind at that time? You think he's pushing to make a big play?
Well, we'd like him to read those out, and he had a little pressure on one, and the other one, he just held the ball a little bit too long, and to try and get it downfield then is not a good thing to do. But, hey, he came back, and he made some big plays. And listen, if you watch every week in this league, every quarterback is going to get exposed to all this stuff over a 16-game season, so he's probably not a lot different than most, but after last year, the expectations are higher, and he set the standards. So anything less, people are going to be critical.
What's the one thing you've stressed throughout the practices in terms of Mark Rypien and his mechanic and his delivery?
Well, those are things that he's possessed with those. We don't try and change that as much as we work on being decisive in your drop and reading on the move. So when he hits on that back foot, he will know where he's going to go with the ball and read the play out so that we avoid double coverage.
Okay, Rod, thank you very much for stopping by.
Thanks, Rocky.
Okay, Rod Dowhower, quarterback coach of the Redskins. And speaking of the quarterbacks, Mark Rypien is now holding fourth. Let's go back to RFK.
The way they played against Dallas, they could stick to a scheme that they thought would work. And so we worked hard on that all week. And I think our three wide receivers that we started using the second half, you know, did a lot of good things in the running game and hit some plays in the passing game. So, you know, we felt good. Our defense gave us opportunities by getting us the football. And, you know, it was a big win for us. And this is hopefully the start of some good things for this football team.
How important was it to score right off the bat and get some confidence going?
I think, you know, that first drive, you know, the way we've been kind of milling around here the last 4 or 5 weeks, you know, I think it was, you know, imperative for us offensively and, you know, getting some guys back now. And I mean, starting to get a little bit of timing. It was just a great drive, and took the ball there, then took that 94-yard drive in the second half, So, you know, that for us is the kind of football we like to do. You know, do some things in the running game, you know, throw possession passes and then hit some big plays, which I think we did.
How do you feel overall about your performance?
Well, like I say, I thought, you know, one bad throw I made there in the beginning of the second half, and then the one right before halftime where we kind of got in the mix-up there. Coach had called two plays, and which I think was a good move. You know, you call timeout, and they're thinking you're going to throw the pass, you know, when you come back out in the field. So we had two plays called, and the first one we came close to scoring on. We came right back in line of scrimmage, and, you know, I just threw a ball that was a little bit too far to Ronnie. So that wasn't a missed opportunity, but, you know, I thought we played a good first half. Controlled the ball, did some good things. Our defense gave us some opportunities. In the second half, outside of the one throw to Ricky on the scramble, I thought, for the most part, we did some real good things.
Were you getting more time back there?
Yeah, they played real soft and, you know, kind of changed things up from, you know, what they had done in the past and gave us a lot of time because they only basically had a four-man rush. So we had a chance to hit some underneath routes and then get the one, you know, down the sideline to Gary there in the fourth quarter.
Rep, can you compare the confidence factor you had after putting it in this week compared to the long drive open the last game where you didn't get it in?
Well, you know, like I say, I think it's for us, you know, closing things is what we like to do. And we've been a team when we've gotten our opportunities, we've made the most of them. And so far this year, we haven't, you know, been able to capitalize. So for all of us, I think it was just a real, real nice situation, you know, to have a control the ball, hit some first downs and third downs. And that's, you know, that's the type of football we like to play. So I think we really felt good about that. And hopefully that'll give us some confidence here down the stretch.
Very, very key word, confidence. Four offensive touchdowns in the previous six games, mm-hmm. and five today. I mean, well, five touchdowns. One of them was defensive. But from a confidence standpoint, very, very important football game.
It is. It could be misleading. And I hope folks don't get overconfident behind this because they're going to have to go out and play much better football teams in order to make it into playoffs and be successful. But we'll take anything at this point. It still comes down to execution. There were some things in there that I'm sure the staff will scrutinize throughout the week that today they won't mention.
Still have some more highlights to look at and some more people to hear from at RFK. The Redskin Postgame Show, back after this.
I want value, so I check out the new Toyota Corolla. More room, real smooth and quiet. Lots of safety features.
Corolla is rated a best overall value. It costs less to own. Count on it.
That's what I want, a car I can count on.
Count on this, too. Right now, there's a special limited-time lease offer from Toyota.
I got a new Corolla with air conditioning, power steering, and a great radio for only $179 a month.
Come in now and lease a new Toyota while this special offer lasts.
When you move into a new house, little things are going to come up. Unexpected things. Things the previous owner forgot to mention. So to make your new house a home, turn to the book with more choices. It can even help if you want to get out of the house for a while. The genuine C&P telephone yellow pages. 9 out of 10 use it. No other book can match it. A better antique company.
If you're looking for the perfect gift, why go around in circles looking for somewhere to park? Or spend hours pushing and shoving through crowds?
Pardon me, by the mic.
Instead, come to TGI Fridays for Friday's gift certificates. They're a great way to give someone the gift of great food and good times. So come to Fridays or call now at 1-800-GET-TGIF to order your Friday's gift certificates.
Do you remember that story about the three bears? This was too big. That was too small. And finally, something fit just right. Like the J30 from Infiniti. Now that's my definition of luxury. It's a car you just slip right into. And live happily ever after. Infiniti. Makes you want to take up driving again, doesn't it?
What a race. First in the Far East, Middle East.
First in Europe and Africa. Yes! DHL's first worldwide.
An independent study proves DHL delivers packages around the world before either Federal Express or UPS. Research confirms DHL is faster to more of the world.
We're back live and still waiting for second place.
Oh, here they come now.
When we left our highlights, it was 14-3 Redskins after the first quarter. It was 20-3 at halftime, but a lot of fun getting there. And we mentioned Brian Mitchell, and you've heard everybody talk about Brian Mitchell coming up under center. I think the first interesting play of the second quarter was
certainly
just
was.
That. We looked up at the monitors and said, whoa. Somebody is out of position. But here he comes. Brian Mitchell is under center and Mark Rypien in the slot. And Brian Mitchell comes running out. He gains 8 yards on this play. But then, face mask penalty on the sideline, turns out to be a 23-yard play and very important.
Couldn't ask for anything more than that. And he showed us, I guess you made a good point about the body bag game. He can actually throw.
That's right. He was the most impressive guy 2 years ago up in Philadelphia. Here's the one that you thought was a really bad decision. Into double coverage. In fact, even Rypien mentioned it in the news conference. He just didn't check down and threw to his number one receiver covered twice.
Yeah, you got to get away from that.
Now, we mentioned Jim Lachey coming back. This is an 11-yard Ernest Biner run. And what makes it? It's the old counter tray. And watch Raleigh McKenzie and big number 79, Jim Lachey, coming across on the tracks.
Encouraging moment in the archives of Hog football. I mean, that's a big hit there, big confidence builder. You look at Ray Brown still pushing that pile, reminds you shades of yesterday.
And it set up the 32-yard Chip Lowmiller field goal and a 17-3 Redskin lead. And then I think this is a real turning point in this football game. Even though it's 17-3, watch this. Ricky Prohl catches the ball. Again, Brad Edwards is in on the stick. The ball gets loose, and here comes Wilbur Marshall. He runs 30 yards, gets into traffic. He gets hit by four or five guys, breaks free of that, cuts it back across. He might be running out of gas. Give it to Al Voigt.
Oh, yeah, but here's the great thing about it. Watch 58. Marshall will come in now and get a block.
Right there.
I mean, the guy, defensive player of the year, maybe the century at this point.
Turns out to be a 56-yard interception play, goes back the other way. And then Ron Middleton makes only his second catch of the game, wide open over the middle, tight end like
score,
yourself, Doc.
Score!
You say this thing's there all the time.
Oh, right? It's there year in and year out.
But Middleton, a little
rough right here. A little too much air on it right there, Ripster. Hey, you can't lead a hog. You got to hit a hog right between his belly.
It's almost like Russ Grimm last year, right?
He's short-armed, too. Come on, Ronnie, put up two arms.
And as the first half ended, Chip Lowmiller lined it up, the 13-yard, basically extra point type field goal, and the Redskins went to the locker room with the 20-3 lead. Now, they led 17-0 out in Phoenix on October 4th, and, you know, you felt that that was safe. Well, they came out here again, and who's that? Robert Massey, the guy that ran it back in twice on him out there, and, you know, right away,
a lot of folks thought
Mark Rypien throws it to him. That's right.
What? Now, Rosenbaum, I thought, well, he just played terrible, made some throws that, I mean, we didn't see that in Damascus or Gaithersburg in high school championships. I mean, the guy was terrible.
And Edwards, just playing center field, read that absolutely perfectly, stepped in on it. Gary Clark, though, off of him, right between the numbers to Tim McDonald. This period started out with four interceptions being the big plays of the period. I mean, weren't guys wearing number 80s that were catching?
It was a real stinker, especially in the quarterback position.
And then here's Todd Bowles. And if Todd Bowles didn't intercept this, Monty Coleman might have, or at least knocked it down. And look at Todd Bowles.
Couldn't lose at that.
He comes back 60-some yards back into Cardinal territory.
Temple Owl, look at him. You can believe the guy's sucking on eggs right there, too. He is beat to death.
So that got it to the 33, and then the power game took over again. Ernest Biner managed to crack in, and that's where Ray Brown, nicked as he was, just drove the defensive lineman back into the end zone, and 27-3, and now things started looking pretty safe as they got into the fourth quarter. We'll take a look at that fourth quarter and hopefully go back to RFK to hear from some more Redskins as the Redskin postgame show continues.
Sells balloons. Bob sells balloons. Bert sells wacky gifts. Bob sells wacky gifts. Bert delivers. Bob delivers. So if Bob's got everything Bert's got, why's Bert busy and Bob not? Now, do you suppose Bert's got a big color ad in the book 9 out of 10 people use?
The genuine C&P telephone yellow pages.
9 out of 10 use it. No other book can match it. A Bell Atlantic company.
Here's a great idea for the holiday weekend.
save some money.
Saving money, I like that.
Then see your Toyota dealer now. There's great holiday deals on Camrys, Curcells, Corollas, and Celicas. Some have option package savings up to $1,500. The values are terrific.
I got a great deal.
Holiday deals means Toyota's price to sell now. There's tough Toyota trucks with factory to dealer incentives. It only lasts a few days, so get to your Toyota dealer today.
Something strange happens to serious do-it-yourselfers when they see one of our new Hechinger Home Project Centers. Is it the enormous kitchen and bath display? The hundreds of power tools? 5,000 doors? The new lawn and garden center? Whatever it is, two big new Hechinger Home Project Centers are now open in Reston and Fairfax Circle. And do-it-yourselfers finally have a place to get serious.
Now, I've been to a few doctors in my time, and
it's like I'm sick. I feel bad. Can I get this little human sympathy here?
And you don't want to go through a lot of rigmarole just to change doctors.
Well, make it so a guy that's not a brain surgeon understands
you. You'd like to know up front, is this covered? Is this not covered?
I'd say great. They realize my time is worth something.
I want to know that the care I'm getting is just as good as they're giving the person in the next room.
They could just make those gowns come all the way together in the back.
Ladies and gentlemen, feast your eyes on the elegant J30. A classic luxury sedan in an infinity kind of way. A driver's car with two airbags, soft leather appointments, and tasty wood. Hey, pal, don't you even think about it. The Infiniti J30 luxury sedan.
The Redskin Postgame Show has been brought to you by the C&P Telephone Yellow Pages. No other book can match it. A Bell Atlantic company. And by your local Toyota dealer, where you'll find great values like the all-new Toyota Corolla. For quality, value, and the best deal going, see your local Toyota dealer today.
Jersey number 27 was worn by a man possessed today, Mr. Brad Edwards. Three of the five Redskin interceptions in Brad's at RFK. Brad, a little bit of a struggle in New Orleans, but a glorious day today for you. What constitutes such a turnaround for this team and for yourself?
Well, I think really was the importance of the game. Obviously, we came out of last week. I think myself in particular, I didn't play well last week. I don't think as a team we played well in such a crucial, pivotal game for the playoff race. And coming into this game, we felt like obviously we had to win or else we go to 6-6 and 500, and it's almost impossible after that point with our home stretch here coming on to get in the playoffs.
I have not seen as much outright emotion from a Redskin ball club, especially on the defensive side. You guys were yipping and yelping and talking a little trash like when you knocked down Larry Setters. I mean, I've not seen so much animation from you guys in a long time.
I agree. I think today we really came through and we're real jacked up, and they helped us do it. They were playing real aggressive, and we're kind of pushing guys after the play, and it really got us pumped up, kind of going into the game as the game got going on.
Werbel's always punched up, but I think everybody else pretty much took on the lead. Brad, after the first interception, you had to be surprised. I mean, the guy threw it flat right in the bread basket. You read it well. He didn't look you off, and you had to think, I had to pinch myself.
Yeah, I saw it coming, and I kind of think for a minute he thought we were in a little, because we gave him a little zone look, and actually we were playing man, and we're kind of rolling over to, I was kind of rolling over to help the cornerback over on the left side, and actually I don't think he expected me to really sink down that low, and when the ball came to me, it almost scared me. I mean, I was like, oh, you can't drop this, so it really helped. I mean, you got to get something like that sometimes.
His confidence obviously blown. I mean, Chandler had been playing so well. Rosenbaum just taken, 2 years ago, and he was really something to be some promise.
Yeah, it's a tough situation for him coming in, being out, missing so much time, virtually all of last year, a good part of this year, coming in, getting kind of a tune-up last week. That's kind of a tough situation to come into, and it, especially against a team like us, who, we had to really come through and play well, get a lot of pressure on him, and I think we did that today.
What did it mean to have Darryl Green start this football game and know that you could rely on his man-to-man expertise?
You know, when Darryl steps out there, it gets me jacked up because he's such a competitor, and no matter what the situation is, he's in there getting all the guys pumped up. And really, in my mind, a lot of times I almost cut that side of the field off in terms of who I want to help out or whatever because he does such a great job out there.
Brad, all this week we knew that Joe had to try and make it fun, make it interesting again. And sitting alongside of you now is Brian Mitchell, who probably put as many smiles on faces in two plays as anybody in this football game. What did you guys think you obviously knew it was in the package, but when you saw Brian under center, did it lift the whole team?
I'm just tired of Brian killing us in practice every day. I'm glad seeing him get a chance to do it to somebody else. And we got real excited. You know, anytime you mix things up like that, it was a lot of fun.
Brian, describe those plays to us, how they were designed and strictly runs for you all the way or option pass in there anywhere?
Well, the first play is basically I fake a reverse and then I come out, and if the guys come up on me and leave art open, I'll throw the pass to him. But if not, I just call run and I run the ball. The second play is a design, is an option with a. I go in the game, and if they're in a defense that we're not, you know, comfortable with running the play, I'll check off to any of five different passes.
Was that really put in to just lift spirits, or did they see it as a bona fide weapon in this game?
Well, I don't know why they put it in, but I think, you know, Coach Bro, he was saying that. They have a couple plays where they got the ball in my hands, and I think I look at it as we have three good running backs that are, you know, playing. They're playing well, and it's hard for me to get the ball. So I think they just tried to get a way to both lift the spirits of the team and then again get the ball in my hands. And I'm glad that they did. You know, it made me feel real good, and I think that it pumped up everybody on the sideline. They wanted to see the play running. When I never really run around people, I'm always trying to run over people, and I think that excites them.
Brian, you know, when you look at it, Desmond Howard got some plays, yourself, Matt Elliott at center. How often did you and Matt have to work this week on the center exchange? I thought that was the most important part of the play.
Well, we ran the play, I think, about six times. Well, we ran six plays this week where I took the snap from him, and that's all. And we took two snaps right before the game. But every day I'm taking snaps from our guy Bingham because we have so many different fakes off of punts. I have to take snaps from him sometimes. Other times they have to snap the ball directly to me. And I think, you know, the fact that I'm always with Guy every day makes it a lot easier.
Can we expect to see you throw deep in the near future?
All right.
Okay, Brian, thank you and Brad for
stopping by.
We're flying out of time here. Gary Clark did catch a touchdown pass in the fourth quarter, and Kerry Conklin got his first ever through to Art Monk. Monk's first touchdown catch of the year, and Al Boyd Mays with an interception. We'll have all the scores for you at 6:30 on Eyewitness News. One game of note, though, the Green Bay Packers defeated the Tampa Bay Buccaneers by the score of 19-14, so the Packers still just one game behind the Redskins in the playoff hunt. That's it for Rick Doc Walker and Al Koken. I'm Ken Mease, and that's the Redskins postgame show. Thank you for being with us.